I'm gonna wait for that to... Hang on, show me. I'm not playing. Hello. Welcome to Misery Mike. I'm Vitreous. Back before the show had a name, last time, I mentioned that I was gonna do a challenge run on Super Mario World. Now I'm here to tell you that I lied. Well, it wasn't at first. My computer needed work, but I removed a large chunk of recordings, including the footage. But I think I got a challenge that'll make it up to you. Today, I am starting my next challenge, 100% run on Donkey Kong Country 2, Diddy Kong's Quest. By this, I mean I will use one single life to run through each level, get every DK coin and Chrome coin in the level, without having to return to it later. I can retry the mini-game challenges in the level, but at the level itself. Also, to prevent me from losing my mind, I'm splitting each area in two. It's also so the videos aren't super long, but I like the first reason better. The boss of each area will be on the second video. And without further delay, this is Donkey Kong Country 2, Diddy Kong's Quest. Okay, let's get going. First slot. One player because I'm a loner. World 1, Gangplank Galleon. Level 1, Air Panic. Oh no, I've run out of things to, narrate. Go in here, you can get a nice message from King K. Rool saying he's kidnapped Donkey Kong and you'll never see him again. Why is this called Donkey Kong Country, and not Diddy Kong tries to save the world himself? Beyond me. My guess is Donkey Kong Country is clearly a better title than what I just came up with. These are Neeks. Rat-type enemies. Why can't I call them rats? Are beyond me. Actually, my guess would be it's because it's a video game. Nothing can be named easily. These are clops. Go down here and we reach our first mini game. Find the token. Where could it be? Well, the banana's this way. Oh, look at that. About as hard as 2 plus 2. There are slight differences between the two Kongs. Diddy Kong can do that, cartwheel thing I showed you. Dixie Kong does this little hair flip trick. And Rambi can run really fast. Use that tactic to go through the wall here! Destroy them all! Keep running, don't get hit by enemies! Go, go! And with that, we get our first DK coin. Get it in plain sight. And K-O-N-G spells Kong, giving me an extra life. 2 lives to Rambi. Altogether, 6 extra lives, 1 level. What is the definition of tutorial again? Pretty sure that stage is. Looking at the title, you can see that an explanation point's been added and the DK coin symbol. Explanation points are added when you collect all of the, Kremlin tokens in each stage. The DK coin clearly represents I found the DK coin. It's very helpful in a challenge run like this. Use Dixie to hover over the gap and get to the first bonus barrel of this level. Climb up really fast. Why did I think this was going to be a hard challenge? Oh well. I clearly do not care about getting all the letters in the stage because, well, I got 10 lives already. In the first levels, I kind of also have to be careful not to trigger the explanation point barrel that's in them. It kind of brings you all the way to the end of the stage, which is a bizarre cheat and not helpful for this challenge. Another 2 lives. Oh, I missed a couple enemies. The things climbing on the ropes are called clingers. They're pains, but not too bad. Ah, Clown got me. Yeah, this is not a perfect run. Maybe I'll try that. These things are called click-clacks. They're not that hard, and the cannonball can get rid of them. Bring the cannonball to the cannons, and you get another challenge. Destroy them all. This one can be tricky. I've played this game before, and it's all too easy to get hit in the back by one of the clingers. Keep climbing up. Wait for him to fall. Go under. Jump over. Find the third and final bonus barrel of this level. Collect the stars. Pretty self-explanatory. You do have to kind of run through this one pretty fast. I found that just trying to take them out by going up and down, pretty much the easiest trick. Otherwise, you're gonna get caught up in the timer. Oops. That you get the fifth Krem coin. This is gonna be a long game if I keep referring to them by the numbers. And by that, you get the 625th Krem coin. 13 lives at the end of level 2. I should really be enjoying this easiness, because it ain't gonna be that easy for long. Last level of this section, Gangplank Galleon. I'm sorry, Gangplank Gallery. Okay, in this challenge, you have to find the coin hidden in one of the boxes. It's not always the last one, it's just the last one I found. Oh, and the time to complain about the name of it. I hate the name of this level. It is not good. They shouldn't have an area called Gangplank Galleon, and one called Gangplank Gallery. Kinda confusing. I think that's the last time I get hit in this video. Twice in 3 levels. I guess that isn't terrible. Use Dixie Kong to hover up there, it makes it easier to grab the hooks. Like I was saying about the Kong's abilities, Dixie Kong can hover using her pigtails. Yeah, okay, that makes almost no sense, but then again, the Sonic franchise, Tails flies by spinning his tails around fast, and Cream can use her ears, so. There are less logical ways to fly, I guess. And to be fair, Dixie Kong only hovers with her hair, so. the treasure chests hidden in this area can be used to find good hidden goods. Just break them over an enemy, and it'll give you what's inside. The big blue things are called crunches. They're kind of reminiscent of an enemy from the original Donkey Kong Country, where if you're Diddy Kong, you'll just be bounced off of him, and you won't die. But if you're Donkey Kong, you'll knock him all the way out. Problem with this is, both Diddy Kong and Dixie Kong are the same size, so the enemy is guaranteed to knock you back, making him pretty much invulnerable. Except to crates, boxes, and, invulnerability. Okay, almost out of the level. And we're done. 18 lives. And with that, I think I'm gonna save. So hear me, Wrinkly Kong, save the game. Showing us if you have 7% of the game complete. Oh god, I only have 7% of the game complete. No! This is gonna be long. For this video, I give the levels a 1. They're not that difficult, they're the definition of tutorial. That's why they're the first 3 levels of the game. Other than a couple of the barrels that are hidden, a lot of them are pretty much just look a little bit to the left. The challenges in each bonus area was easy. Not much thought process had to go into blinking. I hope this challenge gets harder than this, otherwise, well, I'll run through this faster than I did the last videos. Until next time, I'm Vitreous, and I'm doing this to make up for not being able to do the Super Mario World run. I hope it works.